Hello, welcome to MCFC 9320 Group TV. Good evening, guys.
Good evening. How are we? Good evening.
All good. All good in the hood. How's your week been?
Standard.
Been watching plenty of football?
No. Yes and no.
Well, it was advertised as football, but it was something far beyond that, to be honest.
To be honest, I've enjoyed some of the games. Obviously, the games what I've been had more interested in the matches what involve City players. What games have you seen this week?
De Bruyne came on second half.
Rubbish. Very well. Rubbish. It was rubbish. He only no one scored one and an assist.
But that's only an half a game.
Yeah. No, seriously though, I thought he looked incredible and bang on form when he come on. The assist was, you know, top class, and his goal, it was just typical De Bruyne, you know, leathered it with accuracy.
Why is he not wearing a mask if he's got
COVID? No,
if he's got a fractured eye socket,
because you don't need to wear one.
Why has Rudiger still got one on then?
Because he's pathetic.
Yeah.
And he's trying to channel he's in a Phantom of the Opera.
That's a true story, that, Riz.
It is. You don't need to wear one.
But, no, I was going to go back. I'm not going back to the Champions League final. No. Not going there. Let's concentrate on the matches in hand. So, KDB, absolutely phenomenal when he came on.
Yeah.
Anybody watch that drab England-Scotland match on Friday night?
Yeah, I watched it, hoping it was going to be better, but it wasn't. It was dire.
Why? What, Kieran?
Jermaine Jenner's dire. That's how bad it was.
So why did Southgate take Foden off? Because I thought Foden was the best player on the park up until that point.
Well, obviously playing for a draw, weren't he?
Yeah, well, he got it.
And we're through, so that's what he wanted. He didn't want to lose.
He's scared to death of losing, isn't he, Southgate? He's scared to death of going out in early stages. I mean, the team we've got there, the youth and exuberance we've got, we should be just go. They should just say, any one of us four could manage that team and just go, you know what? Go out and enjoy yourselves, lads. Go and express yourself. Go and win it.
Raheem Sterling yet again came in for a lot of stick. Now, yeah, he's not at the best of seasons, but I've actually defended him because we're in an England shirt over the past two matches, because at the end of the day, he's got England 3 points, you know, with a decent goal. He was involved with a draw. Harry Kane gets taken off twice in the two matches. John Stones, I thought, done okay in both matches. Thoughts on Stonesy?
Should have scored a goal.
Yeah, should have scored, definitely.
Should have, would have, could have, didn't.
Should have.
Yeah. But are England that bad? Because they've come under a lot of criticism, you know, since Friday. Is it really that bad? Because the world champions, France, they drew 1-1 with, I was going to say Hungary, but that's a great cue, that, with John eating his food there. Look at that.
That's not food. That's an appetizer for him.
Look at that.
That's a Scooby snack.
And I was just having a snack.
So, yeah, Alex, did you watch the England match?
I haven't watched any matches so far, but I'm planning on watching some next week. I would like to single out some countries that I would like to see teams. And England is one of them, obviously, because a lot of City players are there. And I normally root for England in these kind of tournaments. So,
well, and so you should, since you come from Stockport.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
So, yeah. What's your thoughts, John, on the City contingent for England?
Stones has done well. Sterling played well the first game, because it made us think whether he had a problem at City, because he played fantastic on the first game.
Yeah.
Like you say, he scored the goal that won the 3 points. On the second game, he was just back to the same Sterling that played for City.
I thought he had a couple of good Granted, I had a couple of beers at my mates, but I didn't think it was. Well, I didn't think Sterling was as bad as it. You know, it's being portrayed in the media at the minute. He had a couple of chances. He also nutmegged a Scottish player for, I forget who it was now, who just hit it wide. You know, goals change games. And if that had gone in, am I having a burger there? Is there any cheese on that?
The waitress is just up and dry.
Yeah. Hey, Eddie, the afters is coming. The hot dogs have just been brought in.
Well, yeah, I don't think it was as bad as being portrayed, but you know, that's just me.
I think you're right, Andy, to be honest. I mean, it's typical that the England as a unit play badly is not the right word for it, because they didn't play badly. They just played with no passion and desire. That's what I thought. It looked like a team that's not shown up for the derby. You know, like when City play United sometimes and we just have a lacklustre performance. It looked like that to me, that they weren't up for it. And how an England team can't be up for an England-Scotland game is beyond me. But having said that, you can't pick out any individual City players who played badly. You know, Harry Kane has been non-existent in all these England games so far. And he's had stick for it, to be fair. His second game, he's had quite a lot of stick. And that sounds awful, what I'm going to say, but I'm glad he's getting stick, because at least they're being consistent with it. You know, before, they normally ignore what Harry Kane does. He gets away with doing anything. You know, he's the blue-eyed boy, isn't he?
See, I'm picking up, especially the England lads, the City England lads, that they seem to be getting a little bit of stick more than normal.
Now, absolutely.
I'm not saying there's an agenda by the press, but Sterling, for example, I think it's time that, you know, we protected him, if you like, because, yeah, he didn't have a great season, but if he has a bad tournament, you know, he's not going to start off next season really well for us, is he? So I think the nation should be getting behind that whole England team, and I think it's a little bit poor the way they're being slaughtered at the minute.
But don't you think that's? I mean, we hit on this a little bit last week, and John, you mentioned it on Twitter this week about, is it Calvin Lewin?
Calvin Clark,
that's him, yeah. And it, you know, he had a belting game. The first game was absolutely fantastic. And what do we see in the press? How his Jamaican father's in prison, how his mum had to do this when they were being brought up, and blah, 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 blah. And I just thought, Raheem Sterling, here we go again.
Yeah.
It's disgusting. It's disgusting. And I can only think it's racist to me. Because it doesn't happen to anybody else. It just happens to the young, you know, the young black players. It's not right. It's so not right, and it's so obvious. They're going about, you know, taking a knee and, you know, kick it out and all the rest of it. Then all the press start going on about, oh, it's terrible. So they're the ones that are doing it.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
You know, it's wrong.
It's well documented with, you know, with Raheem Sterling, you know, in I was going to say in the past with the press, but it's still happening. But with Calvin Phillips, the poor kid's been through enough. He's even got to play for Leeds. He's got to live in Leeds.
You know, that's enough.
You know,
he didn't need to say anything else. He plays for Leeds and lives in Leeds. Leave the lad alone.
I absolutely agree with you. So we've covered Belgium slightly, England, Spain, España. Torres, Rodri and Laporte. I think Laporte has had a decent tournament so far. Rodri, I thought he's done all right. Torres has been a little bit in and out, as he is for City, so at least he's consistent. I still think there's more to come from Torres, though, in this tournament.
Is Torres a regular starter for Spain?
He didn't start yesterday, but he started the first match, I believe.
Okay.
So yeah, there's more to come from Torres, I believe. Even the likes of Cesc Fabregas, now he's touting Rodri as, like, he can be as good as Sergio Busquets and stuff like that. So he is highly rated, you know, within, you know, within Spain and stuff like that. So it bodes well, if, you know, if people are looking at him as Sergio Busquets, it's going to be some player though in here, Alex.
Definitely. I think for Rodri, you know, being at City has really done him a favor. And he is now, we can say, a world-class player. I know, you know, people sometimes are harsh on him. I can get why he's not Fernandinho, but he has his own game.
Yeah, you're right.
John, is Rodri world-class?
He can be.
Watch them splinter.
But for me, he needs to be more consistent over the time. There's times when he gives the ball away too much. And it's really in an odd situation at times when he does it. And that's when it basically turns around and it just messes up totally. And they end up, the other team ends up scoring most of the time because it. He loses it in such a position that it we're all forward attacking, and then he loses it, and then just totally, yeah, the other way.
Riz, it was the first name on Pep's team sheet for what, three quarters of the season.
Yeah, I mean, I think when you say world class, I think world class has altered over the recent years. There used to be, you know, an elite. World class of player. I think it's since Messi and Ronaldo have kind of been regular on the scene that everybody sort of uses world class as being them two. And I think other unfortunately most of the other players drop below that. If you take them two out of the equation, is he world class? He's up there as, you know, he's got to be playing in the best league in the world and being in the best team. In the league, so he's got to be up there. Yeah. Whether he's world class or not, it depends what your level of world class is.
How many times do we scream for Fernandinho though to come on instead of him?
Yeah.
Now Fernandinho is world class.
It is.
But we know what we're getting with Fernandinho because he doesn't ever put anything below a 7 or an 8 in. Yeah. You know, he does what he does, and it's methodical. He knows what he's doing. He's experienced. He goes when he should go, and he stays when he should stay. It's as simple as that.
Let's hope he does stay.
Oh, at least another 2 years.
Yeah. So that brings us to Laporte. Has he had a good tournament so far? I think he's had a decent couple of games. To be fair,
I think steady. I think steady's the probably word for him. I don't think anyone has had an outstanding start to the tournament, as is normal in these tournaments. He's a bit, you know, everybody's feeling the way and getting the feet into it. I think we'll start seeing the world-class players coming out in the knockout stages. I think that's when we'll be able to tell who the quality is. You know, the wheat, sowing the wheat from the chaff, as they say.
Yeah, and it's been unusual for Spain as well because he's played on the right. Or left, whichever way you look at it, he's played on the right. Whereas for City, he plays predominantly on the left. So, you know, the versatility and everything's there for him now. But is he staying with us, Alex?
Tough question, to be honest. For me personally, I think it's the best move to be. I think it would be the best move to move him to the left back position.
Why?
Get rid of Mendy. And you have Ake, who is an option, probably on the bench. And you have Laporte. For me, that would be the ideal scenario.
Zinchenko's our best left-back at the club, in my opinion, John.
Yeah, Zinchenko. Even though Zinchenko...
I'm going to keep going to you, John, every time you take a mouthful of food.
I know, you keep saying... Every time I do it, you keep looking at me younger, man.
No, to be fair, Riz... I think Zinchenko is the best left back in the club. So, by all accounts, he will be our regular first choice left back for the start of next season. And I think that's fair comment from Pep.
I hope he does, mate, because out of all the players at that club, well, probably him and Phil Foden, they get it. Zinchenko knows what it is to play at City and what it is to fight for your place. You know what the lad's been through in his life, and he could have gone out on loan or gone for a transfer, and he didn't. He wanted to play in that City team. He wanted to be part of it and learn from the players that are around him. So I know there's no sentiment in football these days, but I think Zinchenko has definitely got a place in that City squad.
I've
got a question for all of you now.
Go on, Alex.
In midfield, I think Zinchenko is one of the best options. But defensively, I would rather take Laporte. Honestly, as a left back, Laporte is better there.
I don't agree.
It depends. Yeah, I mean, I think I would have agreed with you last season, not the one just gone. I think I'd have agreed with you then, but I think he's come on, attacking-wise, I think he's come on leaps and bounds, Zinchenko. I think.
What do you think, John?
Don't speak with your mouth full, John, if you don't mind. It's very rude.
Sorry, Riz, come on.
You know what I'm like, mate? As soon as I see food, I can't concentrate. And then John's making me hungry.
No, seriously, fair shout, Alex, but if Laporte is unsettled and he wants to go to Spain, do we keep an unsettled player?
No.
So it seems like there's a few unsettled players at the moment. However, yeah, we'll get to that shortly. Gundogan, John. Gundogan. Oh,
beautiful pronunciation.
Beautiful. I think he's been cracking this tournament so far.
Yeah.
I think he's ran the German midfield.
Yeah. They're getting better and they're getting used to him now. The first game, there was all over the place.
Yep.
But the second game against Portugal, they took a bit of a slow start, but once they got into it, they were good then.
I think that's been the game of the tournament so far.
Yeah.
I do. I think, there's been
Gundogan running that midfield.
Who?
Gundogan running that midfield. Gundogan.
Gundogan. Gundogan.
Yeah.
How about Sané? Is he playing?
He's not a City player.
Sané?
Yeah.
I don't care about him.
Doesn't matter about it.
You mentioned him. Mentioning food again, aren't you? Will you stop it?
did you know, Alex? His first name is Cheese.
Yeah.
Wow.
His middle name's Leroy, but his first name is actually Cheese.
I thought that's a different podcast. That I thought his middle name was Annam.
Oh, by the way, John, bon appetit.
So, Mons 2, Alexander, Mons 2.
So, do you think it's been all right, Gundogan, John?
Yeah, I think it's been good. I ate that one quick.
He's been good like no one.
Yeah, he Gundogan. Has. He's what's that?
You don't see that 2 minutes ago, that dog was running in and out of that room.
that's the former Liverpool. He's got the former Liverpool player in his hand there, Patrick Berger.
Oh, good knowledge.
See what I did
good
there?
Good knowledge, Sav.
That's
Liverpool.
I know, but
impressive.
Patrick Berger. Come on. Right. Portugal. Diaz.
Oh, dear.
Bernardo. Cancelo is obviously not involved because of he's got COVID. Diaz scored an own goal. I don't think.
At least he's scoring goals.
Yeah.
Wrong net though.
Doesn't matter.
I don't think Diaz has had the best of tournaments so far.
Who cares?
No.
No.
But
if you have a bad tournament, it could lead you into a bad start of the following season. So. Let's hope he finds a bit of form, because I don't think he's been brilliant, Alex.
I think he's not playing with all the world-class City players, has he?
Quite right.
Yeah, but that shouldn't be the factor, I think.
No, I agree.
You know, I disagree, mate. I think in defence it's a big issue. You watch, you know, when David Seaman played for City and he didn't have the England stroke Arsenal defence in front of him, he was a shadow of himself. I think when you're playing in midfield, maybe up front, it's a little bit different. But I think when you're playing as in a back four, back five unit, you know, classic example of that is Vinnie Kompany and Julian Lescott. You put Julian Lescott in a team without Vincent Kompany, he was, I know he listens to the show, he was a nightmare. You put him with Vinnie alongside him, and they were the best centre-back pairing that City had over that winning season. So
you may have put upon a point there, is because it could be also said John Stones plays better with Diaz. So
absolutely.
You know, so maybe there is something in that. So,
and it's the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper's a big impact in that. It's the spine of the team. And, you know, if he's used to playing a certain way with City, it's like John Stones when he played for England, and he that back pass that they were all going on about. If he'd have had a decent ball from Pickford, that wouldn't have happened. That was the goalkeeper's fault, and he took the blame because he's used to playing with better players around him. And, you know, I say it a little bit tongue-in-cheek, but there's a lot of truth in that, that when you've got a team like City playing around you and you're set in a certain way, you come to play with some lesser players in the international squads, you know, you can be made to look stupid because you're not doing as you do on a 9-to-5 basis.
There's been a bit of an uproar in Portugal that Bernardo was taken off in the last game yesterday. I think Bernardo's had a good couple of games so far. John, before you eat your sandwich.
that pass for the first goal, good vision from him. But apparently I heard that he might have had a slight knock, and that's why they took him off. So hopefully he's not injured.
Can't see that, because when he come off, he didn't look as if he was too happy. He's another one who's a little bit apparently unsettled at City, but we'll get onto that shortly with the rumoured transfers in and out. You won't have seen Bernardo then, would you, Alex?
I don't know. I mean, I'm having a hard time believing that story, to be honest. Laporte is different. Okay, that's, you know, I can see why. But Bernardo, I think he's one of the most passionate players, to be honest, in our squad. My personal opinion.
Yeah, he is. Oh, as I said earlier, Cancelo is obviously out. Did you catch the Portugal game yesterday, Riz?
I was at a party, so I kind of missed. I was in and out watching it, and, you know.
Is that a yes or a no? You could be a good taxi driver, you going around the houses, yes or no?
I saw bits of it, so I didn't see it all, so I can't really comment on individual stuff. I just saw the result, and you know, from what I was hearing, they got a bit of a tonking.
To be fair, Portugal could have got back into it late on. If it had gone to 4-3, it'd have been 4-3.
I saw the disallowed goal early doors, that was... Was it even checked by VAR? Because I'm pretty unsure what the rules are on VAR in this tournament, because some things seem to be getting checked and other things don't, and I'm not sure why.
You're right. Sterling should have had a penalty against Scott.
Yeah.
Should have had a penalty.
Yeah, I thought that, definitely.
Won't give him, though.
But the thing is, that what's he called, that Walton clown?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Peter Walton's gone from BT Sports to ITV now, and he does my napper in really good.
Yeah, not enough contact to go down, yet the next one where it is given, it was enough contact to go down. The man's a clown. Get him off.
Yeah, he's a model employee for McDonald's. He's that much of a clown.
Exactly.
Quick question. What's going on with Kyle Walker?
I believe he will start in England's next match.
He hasn't played so far in the competition?
He played first game, didn't he?
Yeah,
he played the first game.
Okay.
See, Alex, we're on it.
You are.
Holland, Nathan Ake. Yeah. Came on as substitute after about 60-odd minutes. didn't have much of an impact. I think it was just a bit of a token substitution.
Yeah, I think there's not much to say really around that.
I think John can say more about that.
John, have you seen Nathan Ake? Sorry, John?
Chew a little faster, John.
Pardon?
Nathan Ake.
Yeah, he didn't do much when he came on, apart from he didn't really stand out at all, just basically a squad player.
Yeah, you got a bit of a burger on your moustache.
Burger relish.
Yeah. So, the last one for the Ukraine, Zinchenko. He played a full 90 minutes.
Is there a skipper in it?
I can eat the burger.
Is there a skipper in
it? He is, mate, yeah. Played the full 90 minutes. Decent match as well. So like I said, John, he's going to be our left back next season. Do you agree with that, our first choice left back?
Yeah, I do actually. Good timing that.
So yeah, right, that's the roundup of our Euro 2020s.
Algeria.
John, what do you what do you think about the next game with Algeria?
Slight delay over in Warrington, isn't there?
It always is over there. They've only got four channels on the telly over there.
Yeah. Right. So I must say as well, on a serious note, it's good to see Christian Eriksen up and about. That was some scary, scary moment, that. Good player, Christian Eriksen. You can tell by all the well wishes that he's a popular player as well.
I'll second that, mate. It was the sad thing is, I think that's probably his footballing career over.
No, apparently he's going to be okay. He's going to have something fitted, and he'll still be able to play.
But he's already been fitted, hasn't he? He's had a fire starter fitted, hasn't he? I mean, a fire starter.
Yeah, fire starter. <That's>,
I meant a heart starter.
What is it, a prodigy?
It's the glasses.
So let's nitty gritty now.
Who's he played for?
He plays for France.
Ah, the nitty gritty.
Yeah. So these are the transfer rumours who are all leaving soon.
Oh, this could be a show on its own, this, mate. All of them.
Bernardo Silva, John. Is he going or is he staying? People can't hear that on a podcast, John.
He's turning French.
Sign language.
Alex, Bernardo Silva, is he staying? Is he going?
He's staying.
He's staying.
We could do a little thing on this, couldn't we? Like make notes. Who gets it right? Mark it down, John.
And who gets the most correct answers gets the wig.
Who's saying he's going? Who's saying he's staying?
I'm staying.
He's going. Thank and Grealish is coming in.
That's what you're saying, Andy.
Looks like I'm the odd man out here, doesn't it?
No,
I've been.
I think.
I resemble accusations.
You think Bernardo is going?
Yes, sir. I think Bernardo will go.
I don't think he's happy since he got accused of being a racist. And I just think he wants out of this country.
I don't think it's a case he wants out of the country. I just think he wants to go to a different one. seriously,
you should have been a politician, you, Andy.
Yeah,
I should have. Can't call me Boris, can they?
Well, Boris the ball.
Yeah. So yeah, I think he will end up in Spain. Whether it's Atletico, not so sure. Because he won't go to Barcelona, will he, John? Because they're skin.
I won't.
Sorry.
Maybe.
So you think he'll stay, Chris?
I did until you mentioned Grealish, and then I forgot about him. And No, he's going.
So
to change my mind then. See, this is the power of this is the beauty of the podcast. And you know, we're all big enough to make it all our hands up when we make a wrong decision. And I was wrong. He's going.
I sought to see him go,
to be honest, but
definitely
he's, you know, he's had four seasons with us, one really good one, and the other two have been pretty average. So,
yeah, but Alex stood there with a brew while the guard of honour went on, which just enough.
Yeah, that's his legendary status. So he can go. He can go now without tarnishing his reputation.
Alex, would Grealish be an upgrade on Bernardo?
I think he's a different player, to be honest. I don't think he would.
You know, he is definitely a different player.
Yeah. With a different haircut.
I can confirm that one. Yeah, I might be
controversial. Not immediately, but long term, possibly.
Might be controversial, this, Riz, but I think he is an upgrade on Bernardo.
I don't think he's controversial, mate. I think you're probably right. I think he gives us something different. He likes to attack and beat a man. I think under Pep, he's going to get even better. And if there are some question marks over his, you know, off the field antics and his ego and all the rest of it, then I think Pep will soon sort that out. And I think we could. I don't think there's a better club in the world for him to come to improve him and make him world class.
I agree, John. Think of all them penalties, what he's going to win, what we're going to miss.
Oh, not be given, yeah.
No, I do you think it'd be an upgrade? Would you be happy if Grealish comes in ahead of...
He's more technical than Bernardo. If we ever need a free kick, so he's the man to get you one. Because, like they say, he's been the most foul player for the last two seasons. If he comes to City, then... He's going to be guaranteed to be fouled, isn't he?
Yeah. Is Sterling going?
No, I don't think he will be.
Me neither.
No, I don't either. I don't think he'll go.
No, I can actually see him signing a new deal because, in all honesty, he's not had the best of seasons, but we know what he can do. If he went to another club, I think he'd deteriorate a little bit and it wouldn't be as effective as he is for City. Do you agree, John?
Hmm.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Hmm. Mm, okay. But Mendy's staying.
Oh God.
What?
Surprised you didn't mention him in the Euros for France.
Yeah. Is he playing for France?
I don't think he's played yet, has he?
Is he in the squad?
No, he's been on Twitter all the
time. Says it all.
Is there social media correspondent?
Yeah.
Right, okay. Yeah.
I think it'd be good business if we can get 20 quid and 10 woodbines for him.
I'll take him to Bulgaria with me on holiday and leave him there. I think that's probably... He's just... Listen, we kind of joke a lot about him and to be honest with you, I feel for the lad. Because since he got his injury, he's not been the same. City fans have stuck with him and stuck with him and stuck with him. And he's only going to get, he's going to get downhill. If he can't get in the squad this season and play some decent performances, we're going to get nothing for him. We've just got to let him go out, put him out alone or something. Just get him away from City for some time and just see what happens. You know, people have talked about selling him. Stick him out alone. Get his confidence back.
Stick him on City. He wouldn't go on loan.
Yeah,
TV is perfect for him.
Do what, sorry, John?
City TV is perfect for him. Him and Natalie Pike together.
Hey.
If we were to sell him right now, what do you guys think would be his price?
What currency?
20 quid and 10 woodbines.
Chinese yuan.
Yeah.
Seriously,
I think we'd probably get 15 million for him.
Yeah, I'm thinking the same.
I'd rip somebody's arm off if we got 15 million for him. Because he's he was full of promise. You know, when he joined us, he started off okay-ish, and then injuries have played a big part in it. But when you see somebody injured, in my opinion, you want to see him working hard, trying to get back. Not,
you know what?
Clowning around.
He would thrive in a team like Leicester that are always hitting on the counter. He would thrive in that kind of team. But in City, where we've got to break teams down all the time, then it just doesn't work with him.
Yeah.
Is that Brendan? Yeah. we may have a player for you.
We'll waive the commission. We'll waive the agent's fee and everything. Tell him.
Brendan doesn't want him. So that's. Can you see anybody else, Riz, leaving us?
I do think there's going to be quite a few ins and outs, to be honest, all around the Premier League this season, to be honest. I've just got this little feeling. Once one moves, there's going to be a load of moving about. I think City's going to lose a couple of players this season. We're going to have to get rid of some baggage so we can bring some in.
Cancelo?
Not sure.
I think he needs to recapture some of that form, because I think he was, in my opinion, he was on course for Premier League player of the season up until the last, 2 months, and then he just declined a little bit.
Well, Portugal ain't performing without him, are they?
No, but what happened with the Premier League players vote and stuff like that, that was in April this year. Not if it had been at Christmas time like it normally is, I think Cancelo would have got a Premier League player of the season. But it isn't to be. So I can't see any major outgoings. You know, the Mahrez one's still dipping in and out. I think Mahrez will stay because he's playing.
He'll stay.
Yeah,
100%.
He's playing the best football of his career. Yeah. You know, he's even said that, and he's even partying with younger Haaland now, isn't he?
Well,
he is.
Yeah, I know, but
no. So that's the outgoing.
He's had his hair done. I'm not into all this, mate. These young footballers that are, you know, trying to make it look at me with all me wearing my pajamas. And I mean, I'm not 100% I'm happy with Phil Foden getting his hair done like that. No, it's not that, mate. It's just, I don't know.
No, he's a fashion consultant.
Yeah, exactly. You didn't see last week's show, did you?
I wasn't able to for some reason.
Exactly. Well, you realise this is my little niche. This is my niche now. I am the fashion consultant. And I've seen them all, and I think it distracts them all for letting your hair down, pardon the pun, when they're out and about, they could do what they want. But it sparks something in my head that I start thinking when they start dyeing the hair and doing stupid stuff. I just think, are you concentrating on it? Are you trying to take distracting other people away from? I don't know. I don't know. I'm waffling on here. I don't know, but right. I'm just not. I'm not with it. I'm not with all these people doing wearing all this. I mean, you saw Lewis Hamilton today. There was pictures of him. What was he wearing? I mean, Lewis. What's that all about? What is that all about?
Listen, this is not the show for you. Going, what are you wearing? It's not the show, mate. You know,
hey.
Alex. Riz is just jealous about hair.
Look, that is up. Is that me angry face on the webcam there?
Yeah, it looks like it.
looks like Bo Selector.
Looks like Telly Savalas.
Oh, something's going on. What's happening?
You're just stuck for some reason.
There we go. Bo Selector.
Ooh, James and his face are stuck like that.
You selected something wrong. So, We spoke about Grealish. I'd love to see Grealish come in, even if it is at the expense of Bernardo. Love Bernardo a bit, but if he's unsettled, get rid. We know Grealish wants to come in. Absolutely. It's a no-brainer for me.
I have to agree, even though I used to be against the Grealish transfer, but to me, it sounds realistic.
What's the script with his socks, though?
Listen. We've got Riz with hair, you with socks. He's a footballer. You know, we want him to perform. It doesn't matter whether he's Lawrence Llewellyn Bowen or whoever. If he could play football, I wouldn't care as long as he plays well for us. Harry Kane.
No. No, he needs a makeover, that lad.
Yeah, but we need a striker, don't we, John? So who would you like to see come in? Who? Who's that? I think we've lost you there a little bit, John.
The lad, is it a lad that plays for Hungary, did you say?
No.
That's Hungarian.
Yeah, Patrick Berger. I still think Harry Kane would be ideal. Oh, have I gone?
Yeah, you've gone, but you're still talking.
Ah, that's fine, as long as you can hear me. I was twiddling about with my little knob then, so...
Pardon?
Oh, you don't get caught doing that, mate. That's an American politician did that. He thought he turned his camera off and he hadn't. And yeah. There we go.
See if I can be erect.
Start calling you Leslie Grantham.
Right, I'm going to say something now that I think Paul touched on this.
No swearing.
A week or so ago.
Have we moved on subjects now? I hope so.
And going off the Euros at the moment, I would say that I would definitely take Lukaku.
Mm. Thank you.
I'm sure a couple of months ago when we first started doing the... Oh, hello again.
Hello. Hey!
Nice, isn't it? I did... Oh, let me look in my little book. I brought Lukaku up. Oh, when was it?
I'll tell you what, if John doesn't slow down eating, he'll be bringing Lukaku back in a bit.
Yeah, it was many, many months ago. I threw the Lukaku one at you all, and you all sneered and laughed and went.
I think if you play it back, I think you'll find I didn't.
I can play it back.
I've been championing him.
But if you go to YouTube and you can dig it out.
Oh, what channel's that on? Is it what's the address for that, Andrew?
It's just look at MCFC 9320 Group TV on YouTube, and you shall find it.
There you go. I will check that out, and I think you'll find.
And don't forget to subscribe.
Yeah. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm with you though, Riz. I think, was it you, John? Lukaku, forget who he used to play for, is a monster.
Mm. He is. He can do us a job for two seasons while we get sort of, what's he called? There you go. I've got his name, Spanish lad, Torres. We get Torres, up to speed, playing up the middle. And we'll bring the lap through. So for two seasons, him and Jesus, our strikers, get them up to speed, and then we're sorted. Yeah. And for a budget price.
I think whoever we bring in, it's important that they're proven in the Premier League rather than... And that might be said, yeah, well, but Aguero wasn't proven in the Premier League.
Aaron, Torres, Rodri, Ruben Diaz.
Yeah, but I think as a striker... I still think Harry Kane, because it fits in with Guardiola's philosophy, where he'll chase back, you know, he'll win pretty much, you know, he'll chase crisp packets what are blown on there.
What, with his weak ankles? He's got ankles like crisp packets, mate.
Uncles or ankles?
Uncles. Ankles.
I know, but can you not say that about every player, that they've got a certain amount of injuries?
No, not Lukaku.
He has his moments.
Not that I can remember.
I would take Kane gladly, but if we don't buy in, if we take Lukaku and Grealish, I'm happy with that.
I think that would be good business, although I think we will bring a left-back in. So is there room for Zinchenko and Mendy there? We've discussed that one, but I do think we will bring a left-back in as well.
Who do you think we'll bring in then, Andy? Left back?
Left back? Don't know. I think it'll be somebody from the continent. It seems like Kieran Trippier, you know, he's available. There's a few people, you know, touting him. And he's, after all, he's a blue as well. You know,
is he?
You know who I would go for?
Stuart Pearce.
Tierney.
Yeah, I do like him, the lad at Arsenal, mate. He is a good player, him. Yeah, I agree there. But, you know, Kieran Trippier. Didn't you know Trippier is a blue, Riz?
I didn't, to be honest, no.
He came through our academy. We sold him to Burnley with Ben
Lee. Yeah, yeah. I know he was at the academy, but I didn't know he was a blue.
He's a boyhood blue, pal.
All right, yeah.
I won't bring him in just because he's a City boy or blue. It does help, though, doesn't it? What's made him a better player is, you know, he's gone over to Atletico and he's got a different education over there now. You know, he's sampled playing, you know, in the Spanish league, so he's a lot more of an accomplished player. So, yeah, I do think that's the left back we're coming in. So, if we had a let's go back to the striker. If we had a choice, Alex, between Lukaku and Harry Kane, who would you go for?
Personally, Harry Kane.
Why?
Just, I like him as a player. I like his new role at Tottenham because he can also create established player in the Premier League, as we all know. I'm not fully sold on Lukaku yet.
Okay, John?
The ideal player would be Kane, but...
Do you think he's able? No, he's Kane. Sorry,
the money. And Daniel Levy.
Yeah, but Lukaku will...
I won't sign him.
Fortune? What, say Fortune? Don't know what I'm saying.
This is how I see it, right? If we get Harry Kane, how old's Harry Kane now? 29, is he?
28.
He looks 30-odd, though, doesn't he? You get Harry Kane in, you might get two seasons out of him if we can keep him injury-free. Then he starts getting old. You know, Pep's looking to get a side together that's young. Get them together while they're all young and then build that side through together to last us for maybe 10 seasons. You don't know. Bringing these old players in, Harry Kane, and I took him 2 seasons ago. What I'm seeing at the moment now looks to me like a player who's hit his peak and he's dropping off. But he's realised that he's not going to win anything and he's going to be staying at Tottenham. He wants a move, but it's too late in his career for me. He could come in. For me, he's a bit of a gamble because if he comes in with his reputation, we've already seen it in this World Cup that as soon as he's linked with City, all of a sudden he's not the golden boy anymore, is he? Have you noticed he's getting some stick already? You know, so he comes in to City.
Yeah, you're right. The press are absolutely caning him.
Oh, that's about 6 or 7 tonight, Andy. That's great work. I'd have took him 2 years ago, but not now. I think if we're going to bring a player in, he's too much to bring in as a stopgap player. We're not going to spend 120, 130 million on a stopgap player. And that's what he's going to be if you bring him in at this stage in his career. We want somebody that we can get to stopgap for 30, 40, maybe 50 million. So we've got him for 2 seasons. Cavani at United. It's a classic example of what I'm talking about. If we should have signed him, we could have got him for two seasons or so, brought the youngsters through, got them up to speed, have him in the changing room, bang, we're sorted in the next 2 years.
John, let me throw one at you then. Jesse Lingard. That's an out-of-the-box one, isn't it?
Can't stand him.
No.
Do you care as long as he bangs the goals in?
Yeah.
Okay,
he's too much of a showboater. Whether it was because he was with his best buddy Pogba at United and they both stuck together, and now he's left to go to West Ham, he's actually got better.
That's because he's gone to a bigger club.
Yeah. No, yeah. I won't have him. I won't have him.
No,
I won't. I can't stand the bloke.
Let's scrap that one then.
Jesse Lingard.
We do not want
to. You know where he's from, don't you?
Hmm?
You know where he's from, don't you?
Who? Pogba?
Lingard.
Where's he from?
Warrington.
Is he from Warrington?
Yeah.
He's a big Jesse.
Yeah. Definitely.
Right, okay.
That video of him doing the beans, that just did it for me.
Doing the what?
Beans.
Beans thing.
What's the beans thing?
Oh, Google it.
Google it, yeah.
It's embarrassing.
It is very embarrassing.
I seen him with a parrot on his shoulder.
You said that twice now.
I seen him with a parrot on his shoulder. No.
There's another dad joke coming here, isn't there?
No, that's it.
Okay. That's his joke.
Right, so Laporte goes. Alex, Sergio Ramos is going to come in, is he?
No.
But Laporte...
I would rather stick cocktail sticks in my eyes than Sergio Ramos join us.
Yeah. I think it'd be nice to boil some Liverpool blood, wouldn't it? But we don't need him. We don't need him.
No, we've already got Fernandinho, who's guaranteed us a yellow card and a red card, so we don't need another one.
Why would we want Ramos? How old is he?
Because I think he's about 67 now.
He's New York City.
Yeah.
He's not a City player. He's an Otamendi, if you like.
I was just about to say Otamendi. There you go.
Quicker brains, us youngsters, Alex. Yeah.
We don't need him. He's coming here for a pay packet. We don't want that. No. We're trying to build a team with longevity, and he doesn't do that.
Too old and too slow to play in Spain, then he can't play in the Premier League, can he?
Nope.
I agree with you. I just thought I'd brush that one.
It's very well brought up there, Andrew. Thanks for bringing him in.
He's being linked with us. I just thought I'd throw it out there.
It's Sunday, isn't it?
I think everybody's being linked with us at the moment, though, aren't they?
Yeah.
Even me for 27 million.
They wanted me, you know. It was on Twitter this week. They wanted me as their car mechanic.
No, they wanted you to sell the car, mate.
But that was Barcelona, mate.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. No, I turned Barcelona down.
Did you?
Yeah. Yeah. So, no. It's the repair that's prestige, not the price.
All right. I thought they wanted another player what had been Messi.
That's in a foul my life, that, mate. That's not recent.
Right, hey, I bet you missed me last week, didn't you?
No.
No. Right. Fixtures are out. Our first six games are Spurs away, Norwich at home, Arsenal at home, Leicester away, Southampton at home, and Chelsea away. Bit of a tough start for us, that, isn't it, Alex?
Super start. Super. Yeah, super, super tough start.
Do you need a minute to compose yourself, Alex? Well, we'll go to John first.
No, I'm back. I'm good. Okay. Spurs away. Not a fan of that at all.
1-0 Kane.
That would be the ideal scenario, wouldn't it?
Hmm.
And see him running down the other end of the pitch and knee sliding in front of the thingy.
Knee sliding in front of me.
John, chill your beans. I meant he's still a Spurs player when I said 1-0 Kane.
No, he's not signed for us yet.
Fickle fans, eh? We won't pay that. But look, let's stick to the fixture. I don't think we will we'll pay that much for Kane anyway.
No.
Riz, Spurs away, Norwich at home, Arsenal away, Leicester away, Saints at home, and Chelsea away. So we've got, in the first six fixtures, we've got four tough, tough games.
Well, last season proved don't really matter, does it? As simple as that. The first few games don't really matter because we went and won it by 12 points and we had a rubbish start to the season, didn't we? So there you go.
Yeah.
Next topic.
And it also threw out whoever's top at Christmas. He threw that out as well, didn't he?
Exactly. Yeah. We've all got to play each other. I prefer to play the big teams earlier on before they've hit the ground running than later on. Once you've got the composure.
Yeah,
let's not forget that we're playing one game before the start of the season, the Community Shield.
No, exactly. We're not. We've also playing Barcelona away, Alex. In their trophy.
It's more of a cattle market, isn't it? It's more to see if there's any of our players that they've not tried to buy yet.
However,
if any slip through the net, it's not a friendly, is it?
However, the last time we played them in that competition, we beat them away at the New Camp.
Yeah.
Right, here's one for you, and you'll gain my respect even more than I do anyway. If you can tell me who scored the winner for us,
Garcia.
I know this.
It was the question, Riz.
Oh, I know it.
Go on, then.
McManaman.
Nope. Come on, John.
He played, though, didn't he?
He pointed.
It's the only good game he had.
Come on, John. You've not even got a mouthful of burger and you still...
I can't remember.
Do you want me to tell you?
Yeah.
And there's a link here as well between you and Alex. Here is.
Oh, Bulgaria. Bozhanov. Yes, I knew it. I was about to say that.
You like that one here? See? So, yeah. And Richard Dunn was captain and he lifted that little trophy thing up and Messi was clapping him.
Good. Great memories.
Do you like that bit of knowledge?
You know what? I prefer it when you've been on every week, mate, because when you seem to not be on one week, you come back with a book full of knowledge.
My book's down there now, mate, because the fixtures don't
matter. Out the window, yeah.
Fixtures don't matter, do they?
Would you reckon Aguero score against us?
No. No, I definitely don't think he will.
Yeah.
I don't think he'll play.
Yeah, that's a mark of respect.
Yeah. Will Laporte play against us, though, John?
No.
I hope Garcia does.
Playing for us.
Garcia.
Hope he does. If he scores, we are jinxed and we need to get the gypsies in again and get the lucky pegs out because there's a curse on the Etihad. If Garcia scores against us, that's it. I'm done, mate.
I'll just get my coat and lock up.
Yeah, we're done.
Is there anything else you want to bring up? We brought a lot up tonight.
John's about to bring his burger up, I think. I know,
it's staying down there.
Speedy yet, that.
That's what they call it, fast food.
Yeah.
I think when you do the edit, I think you need some sort of like slow motion action of John eating his burger, you know, like with that Je T'aime music playing. John all sexy eating his burger.
Oh, come on. I don't want that thought.
Hey, you want to see him on holiday, mate? When we go on these European trips.
I've seen some of them pictures.
It's like Diet Coke break. He'll be there with him and his brother will both have matching vests. Stood there on the balcony with the Y fronts on and he'll be there eating, seductively eating burgers.
What? Why have I got Rabsee Nesbitt in my head?
I don't know. Why have you got Rabsee Nesbitt in your head?
What Riz was talking about, I just...
With his vest on.
And burger in the mouth and Rabsee Nesbitt.
The pair of them do. It's more Last of the Summer Wine than Rabsee Nesbitt, if I must say.
So, what's the this week going to bring for you? You're going to actually watch some football, you three, or what?
Yep. Tuesday, aren't we? We're on again Tuesday.
What's on Tuesday?
England.
It's 2-for-1 at Domino's, Alex.
Do they have Uber Eats in Bulgaria?
No, but some local, you know...
Taxi driver.
Similar stuff, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
They have it in Porto, don't they?
Say again?
They have it in Porto.
Oh, yeah, we had breakfast. We didn't move out of the flat, did we?
Yes, I saw the video. Anyway.
Moving on.
So, yeah, it's a huge week of football coming up. I could tell you who's playing this week, but I just throw my book away before.
Has anybody like myself kind of underwhelmed by the Euros this time? Is it because of the pandemic we've come out of? Yeah.
It's throwing me because it's still Euro 2020. So on that premise, I'm not 50 January just gone. I was 49.
I won't own up to that, mate.
I think Riz can, you know, look back in the past tense and see how...
Oh, yeah.
He already knows all the results.
Yeah.
So...
The spirits are with me.
Are we going to beat the Czech Republic septic peg?
Oh, let's have a think. Oh,
do we really want to win the group though?
Yeah. No.
We'll end up with a tougher game.
Listen, we've got to go out to win it. We can't even go if we get beat, we're out. We've got to win the group. We want to win the group.
We cannot play for a draw. If we play for a draw, it is dangerous that.
That's what Southgate does. Captain Waistcoat, that's what he plays for a draw. He is scared to death of getting beat. he's scared to death of them getting lambasted by the British press, because that's what's going
to
happen.
You know the best way to, for him to avoid that? Play his best team and keep his best team out. It's as simple as that.
No, you're right.
He's no Guardiola, is he? So, no. Yeah, so we've got tomorrow night. Tomorrow night we've got Belgium, I believe. I think Kev will start that one.
With Lukaku. Let's see them two hit it off.
I'm going to watch that game.
I already have.
You've already watched the game, John?
No.
Hang on a minute, mate. I'm the psychic one. You do your own thing. I'm the psychic one who does the fashion and stuff.
You're his sidekick?
Belgium went 3-1.
Did they?
There you go.
Was that a good match?
Yeah, fantastic. De Bruyne, 2 assists, 1 goal.
That's not bad, that. Considering he didn't get off the bench.
Lukaku scored the other two.
Yeah.
One of them was an own goal.
Anything else before we go?
Just trying to think what people are talking about on social media, and it's just the same old.
Same old, isn't it?
Yeah. I've blocked all the in the know stuff now, though, because they don't know.
Yeah.
How do you know they don't know?
Because they don't. It's just the same. One person's retweeting, and then it just, everybody retweets it and follows it, and it becomes...
Did you see what Laporte put out on Twitter?
Yeah.
No. He actually called out that reporter, didn't he?
Which one?
There was one from Spain that tweeted out something, and he actually quoted his tweet saying it's all lies. You don't know what you're talking about, basically.
About what? Have I been asleep today?
About saying he's not happy. About saying Laporte's not happy.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
He said, you completely took me out of context. I didn't say any of that. I mean, you might not have seen it, Andy, because it was in Portuguese. I had to Google Translate it. I couldn't find an English copy of it. Yeah, I couldn't find an English version of it.
You couldn't find an English virgin?
Well, you're not wrong there, mate.
Right, guys. I think we better leave it there.
And on that note...
Lovely to catch up with you, and we'll do it all again next week. So,
great to see you all, guys.
And it would be appreciated if you actually did some research and watched some football this week.
Yeah, but then it's not off the cuff, is it? It's rehearsed.
I suppose so.
Yeah.
You do all the research for us. You ask the questions and we deliver the answers. That's what it's...
You're a bit of knowledge coming forward, and then I just send it all back to you.
I'm the oracle.
Exactly.
Used to be CFAX, though.
Yeah.
You are full of facts. John, next week, can you have your tea a bit earlier as well, if you don't mind me saying? I hate coming right at somebody's house when they're having a tea. There's nothing worse, is there?
Well, I just got back, so...
Not interested, mate. Sort yourself out. You know what happens at 8 o'clock. It's like Cracker Jack on a Friday, mate. 8 o'clock, bang on here.
You know what happens at 8 o'clock?
I don't want to know.
Sometimes he's asleep.
he's actually relishing next week already.
Oh, God. That's about 9. That's 9 you've got in.
On that note, guys, have a splendid week, and we'll do it all again next week.